Welcome back to Prime Time. We're doing special coverage here, and what a night we have seen. Just minutes ago, we heard from the president again. He said things are going, quote, better than anybody could have expected, top of the line, and that he and Kim are headed to a signing. But then they wound up going in different directions after the president apparently showed Kim Jong Un his car. Let's take a listen to the sound.
Doing great. We had a really fantastic meeting. A lot of progress. Really very positive. I think better than anybody could have expected. Top of the line. Really good. We're going right now for a signing.
We don't know. And the substance matters, not just from a peace perspective, but a political one. Remember this. The president's party here in the United States would have crushed Barack Obama for doing something like this. They went after him in damning fashion for his lighter assessments of dealing with despots without preconditions. And yet, here we are. So Trump is going to have to bring home something more than a photo op, but we have a lot of day left in Singapore. So let's bring in Will Ripley. He's on the scene there. Will, signing, but then they check out the beast, the president's big Cadillac, and then they walk in different directions. What does signing mean on the ground there?
We know that there were 11th-hour meetings here in Singapore yesterday, lower-level meetings between the United States and North Korea, and they were working towards some kind of a joint statement, some kind of an agreement that could come out at the end of the summit. We know that they had difficulty getting there because of the vastly different definitions of denuclearization that the United States and North Korea have. But then everything seemed to actually wrap up kind of quickly. They announced the changes to the schedule, President Trump and Kim Jong-un both departing hours earlier from Singapore than they had originally planned. A lot of people weren't sure what that meant. It now seems as if they were able to come to some sort of an agreement, and whatever they're going to be signing, you know, obviously the discussions went well, as President Trump said. I can tell you, Chris, I was chatting with North Koreans over the weekend. North Korean officials I was meeting with said that there was no option on their end for this not to go well. So they were expecting this to go well. The North Koreans went and prepared. Apparently, they knew exactly what to say to President Trump.
Well, remember, from their perspective, it has already gone well. Just having parity, look at the North Korean flags right next to the American flag. I mean, whoever thought we would see that? And it's interesting, on social media here, people are saying, no, they weren't looking at a car, it was something else. We just showed you the video again. We know that these men were trying to find ways to bond in just like a personal human way. And what's more natural for guys to want to check out one another's car? You know, as simple as it sounds, here it is again. That's the beast, the president's special motorcade car. And there's Kim Jong-un checking out the inside of it. And then they walk away. So optics are as big a part of this day as anything, Will. There is an audience back home for each of these men. What do we know about how much of this is being reported in North Korea?
So North Korean state media did take the extraordinary step of reporting about this summit before it actually happened. They filed a couple of different reports. They mentioned that Kim Jong-un was coming to Singapore. They talked about his sightseeing tour of the Marina Bay Sands behind me and some of the other landmarks here around Singapore. But at this moment inside North Korea, people are in the dark because state TV is still on color bars. It doesn't come on the air until 3 o'clock in the afternoon, a little more than 2 hours from right now. So we don't know if at 3 p.m. Ri Chun-hee, the senior newsreader who we always see when there's big news in North Korea, will come on with some sort of an announcement and video and photos, because we know that Kim Jong-un has a small army of photographers following him around here, or will the bulletin come later in the day and the pictures come later in the day. But we have seen North Korea be much more transparent about this summit than previous events, including the inter-Korean summit that happened earlier this year with President Moon Jae-in. And again, I was saying, I think the reason why they were reporting about it ahead of time is because they were very confident that this summit was going to go well. And as you mentioned, Chris, it really already has gone well from the North Korean perspective, really regardless of what this joint statement says.